So why not just get a regular old guy? You know, I mean, you just want someone to be, any guy could do that.
What?
Companionship. We need to match mentally. We got to be on the same accord.
Any guy could give you guys companionship, right? If you want someone to shovel snow, man, you going to get a man that's 400 pounds. You know?
No, I don't want no man that's 400 pounds. Dago. No, I got to have me a man that's lean and slim and trim and shape and all that kind of stuff.
Who's saying that, Moshe or Crystal?
Me, Crystal.
All right, so you want a man that's lean and all of that? So then you have to get like that then, Crystal.
No, I don't. I can have a man that's lean. There's plenty of lean and men that are in shape that take on me.
Come on, Crystal.
Okay, so you don't think that's a biased perspective?
I've never been attracted to round men. I like my men lean. And just because I'm big, fat, overweight, no shape, don't mean you can.
So... again, Crystal, let's be a little more realistic here, right? So, you think that have anything to do with you being a virgin still? I mean, let's just be a little realistic. I believe that your stakes are too high. Okay. I have to let you down easy, but think of it like this, Crystal. Guys is fit. They usually want someone that's fit, right then, that's shapely. But
then I just have to get fit. But until
then, let me. But hold on, Crystal. You don't think that's bias?
Uh huh. Yeah, that's bias. Oh yeah. We're all the people we're attracted to.
Yeah, but so let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Let's be realistic. That requires a lot of discipline, right? Amanda's lean and thick. Especially as you age, you're gonna have to eat correctly. That requires discipline. So why do you feel entitled to something that you're not willing to do yourself?
I am willing to do it. I just need somebody to help and motivate me. That's all.
No, you gotta be willing to do this on your own.
And the lean and
because thick- what if they leave, then that all of that leaves.
Huh? What'd you say?
What if they leave? Then all of that leaves. Lean and fit, huh?
Yeah. Men are leaders and providers. They are the head, and they're supposed to be strong, fit, and, you know, powerful and in control.
Okay, and women are supposed to be slim, curvy, and beautiful.
And we're nurturing and
no, and- no. Right, let me tell you something. More so than women, I'm going to be realistic with you, and I'm not portraying theatrics. A man's initial attraction to a woman is going to be physical.
Okay. Yes.
That's his initial attraction. Listen, the way that a woman's body is shaped, men are attracted to things that move. Now, it sounds carnal, but even men that's in the truth, if he wants a wife that he's going to be with, she needs to try her best to maintain the physique that she had when he first met her. That keeps him interested. Right? So men are attracted to things that move by nature, right? Mm-hmm. So a man is going to be much more attracted to a woman that has a shapely body than a woman that's shaped like a pear or a watermelon. Just to put that in your head, right? I mean, it's just... Kadar, am I lying?
Not at all. I know what I like.
There, now, hold on, Crystal. Now, there are some men that's attracted to what they call BBW, big, beautiful women. Well, there are some of those out there. I don't know. Maybe there's some on the call. But, you know, I just think it's pretty biased that you want a man that's fit, lean, he works out, he's eating properly, and... You just want to be able to be a junk food junkie and a whiner. I don't think that, you know, that's pretty biased.
Yes, it is biased, but I love men who are
Moshe, you still on the call?
Yeah, she's still there.
Can you guys see me?
Oh, she got
Moshe.
And that girl is.
Hold on, I'm coming now.
Moshe, did you hear your sister's response?
She froze up.
Moshe, everybody, I thank y'all for correcting me and instructing me, but I'm telling you.
No, we're not correcting you. I'm just trying to give you a realistic perspective.
Yeah, I do.
Are your states really high like that?
I'm telling you, two big old fat people ain't gonna. Anyway, let me shut up because I need to shut up because I need to be quiet and just listen. You know what I mean?
Now, how would you know anything about sex if you're a virgin, Crystal? It seems like you might have been lying to us.
Huh? Lying to you? But I'm not lying. I'm not lying about anything.
You see the chat room?
Come.
You know what I told you? Wow. Wow. So, Crystal, so if you are a virgin, then how would you know how two big people have sex?
I don't know.
How would you know about anything like that?
I just imagine.
Your imagination could be wrong. When you say this guy is lean, what does this guy need to look like? That because it could be slim, skinny. Like, what does he need to look like?
He can't have a pregnant belly. You gotta have an iron and board stomach. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, you're like really far fetched, man. You know what she said, Moshe? She wants the man to have a washboard stomach.
He can't have six backs.
He can't.
He can't have six backs. He gotta have an iron and board stomach. A man should never have a big old fat belly. A woman should have a big old fat belly, but a man. Now I said a woman.
Where are you getting this from, man?
Men are supposed to have flat stomachs, okay?
Where are you getting this from? You know what, Crystal? I hate to tell you, based on your criteria, I think you're gonna be alone for a long time. I'm gonna let you down easy.
Just because I look like a
Okay, but your expectations are unrealistic.
Men are leaders for pride. You can't be the good just because a woman is. You a man. You're different. Okay. You're supposed to be sexy and strong and lean and disciplined.
Crystal. I can hardly hear you. Can you speak up louder?
Okay. The man is a leader, so you can. A man like you can take a woman like me and lead her into. You can give me the discipline that I never had.
No, a man like Kadar.
What Kadar? No, whatever.
No. Yeah. Man like Kadar, no, not a man no. like me.
Kadar.
I'm too little.
I'm too old guy like Kadar. No, I'm gonna find my ass already high like her. I ain't got time to trying to convert nothing.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Crystal, what about Yasha Beam?
Huh?
What about Yasha Beam? You been wife number three.
Yeah, who was Yasha Beam?
Shay Shay.
Wait a minute. Oh, Kahan, you is funny. He said you could be wife number three. Oh, Father God. Let me go on mute.
Moshe, don't go on mute. I want you to respond to this. Did you hear your sister's expectations?
Yeah, I'm sorry, Kristen. Now, you know I love you, girl, but that's a little biased. I gotta agree with Kahan now. Now, same for me and said that to me. But you know, you're my girl. I didn't want to ever date a fat guy either. I told y'all about that, but now I'm, you know, no. But because of the self-control thing, we need to. So I agree with Kahan on this now. You can't say that, you know, dang.
but more say, she said six packs and all of that. She said six packs and all of that.
Who's the way you playing? You sure she didn't mean the six packs of Corona?
A woman let me confirm. Don't mean a man can be as big as a damn house, okay? Y'all are the leaders. To keep me in shape. I am not. I'm sorry. I'm just not attracted to round. I don't find round attractive. And I understand they don't believe they don't find me attractive, but you know what? It is what it is. And
I feel you, Crystal.
It is as simple as that. How about that?
But Crystal.
T-shirt of the slogan, men cannot be fat. How about that?
Yo, you're breaking up. I can hardly hear you.
Men cannot be fat. How about that?
But hold on, Crystal. Would you say that you're fat?
Yeah, I'm fat.
I can't. You're breaking up.
I said, yes, you're just trying to make me say it over and over and over again.
No, you're really breaking up. Your voice is going up and down.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, I'm a little fat. Yeah.
Just a little, right? But the man can't be fat.
No, you can't. A man are not supposed to be fat. Mm-mm.
So how do you come up with this analogy, man? Where does this come from, Crystal?
Look.
The woman could be fat, but the man can't be.
No, you are the leaders and providers and the supporters and protectors, man. Y'all are the leaders. You can't be big as a damn house, all overweight and out of shape. You can't breathe and you can't lead me. And I'm already, look, I'm the weaker sex. You the stronger sex, okay? You got to get me in order, okay? Okay.
Crystal, no, I'm sorry. I don't agree with that. Because that's putting the whole burden. Well, you know, you're my girl, but I got to keep it real down. I don't agree with that. You're not supposed to go to somebody halfway empty. We supposed to compliment each other. Now, that's putting it...
Right?
That's a little... Hallelujah. Oh, that's what I'm going to say.
Anyway, look. I'm good. I can cook and clean, but that man's gonna have to get me in order and in shape. Okay.
But hold on, Crystal. You might be able to cook and clean, man. But you can't touch your toes.
What?
You can't touch your toes, man.
Yes, I can touch my toes.
You can't, man.
Shut up. I can touch my toes.
You can't touch your toes. And the kind of man you want, you're going to break his legs.
Not going to break nobody's legs.
You better get him some crutches or a wheelchair.
You're trying to joke.
Okay. Why?
You can joke on me because I am overweight.
Hold on, Crystal. Let's be realistic, man. Look, yeah, I have a cousin, right? He's big. Malik. He live in Harlem. I think he live in the Bronx now. He got mad big. He weigh about 360, 370, right? Uh-huh. He's so big that he say he can't get on top of the woman because he gets tired too quick. So she's going to have to get on top of him, right? So he's about your size. And so there's a lot of stuff he can't do, like, intimately that he said he used to do. Just shit, man, she's going to have to get on me. Like, when we walk into the subway, he'd be out of breath. Like, I mean... It's not easy being like that in NYC. We used to walk. I remember once the train was leaving and we was running to get the train. I made it to the train. I made it to the train, but he fell on the pavement. And everybody started laughing, man. Then he said, I got to lose weight. But that only lasts until we got to the corner of Bodega. The two heroes again with all of the extra mayo and cheese. And so you wonder why he's like that.
One of the teachers in IUIC referred to us as lard asses. You lard asses need to get, he's saying we lard asses. So we need help. A lot of us need help. So
man, it's just a matter. You know what? You know what? Even right now, Crystal, I'm fasting right now. How come you can't do it? I'm fasting right now.
Okay.
Just for health reasons. I haven't eaten anything all day since last night. And I don't know when I'm going to stop. Like, I might do it for 48, 72 hours. So if I could do it, how come you can't?
Yes.
And I don't really need to lose weight. I'm just doing to try and cleanse my system. Wow, she coming with it tonight, man.
Can I ask Crystal something, my girl Crystal? Oh, wait, okay. Say you met like a fat man that like that looks like Twister or something. And he came up to you like, Twister, you know they right. I can make you celebrity overnight. And then you'd be like, and then he'd be like, how about we lose weight together? What you gonna do? Would you do that with him? I think that's nice. Why not lose weight together, become better together? Because say now my fear is like, I know a girl when she lost weight, she left this guy, and that was so sad because all the guys was after her and all that. I think how I mentioned that. So that might not be fair to him. And you can't say that you won't change because seeing out of the eyes of a slim person now is a difference. You know what I'm not saying it like that. You're still a wonderful, beautiful girl. You know I love you. But what I'm saying is, would you ever be willing to lose weight with a man? Both of y'all do it together.
If she look, I'm gonna check this out, Moshe. If she lose weight with him, she's gonna lose him. The fat woman that loses weight always lose that guy, man. She eventually leave him. You know why? The problem with that is because she starts getting a lot of different attention from a lot of other men, and she's not used to that attention. So she usually always leave that guy for that someone else. That's why I would never help a woman lose weight or something like that, man. Why? They always end up leaving it, man.
You wouldn't help me to lose weight, Tazadaq.
As a personal trainer, but I don't do that anymore. I don't have time for it. Could I help you? Go to Florida. It's hot down there. You're going to sweat. It's too cold over here. It's like 20 degrees outside right now. Why?
I ain't never been no trainer.
He's 6'2", Crystal. I'm too short. Well, I'm only 5'10".
I ain't never been no trainer.
You went to 6'2". I thought they want a man 6 feet and over.
Well, I'm 5'10". Kahan, you not 5'10", are you?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm 5'5". Okay. Crystal, how tall are you? I'm just saying. Well, so Khan, you wouldn't do like a training thing? Let's say if I get all the ladies and I'd be like, come on now, we'll take Khan to train and Crystal join us. I want to train us. Hallelujah.
Yeah, your pa could train him. She knows how to train. She's very fit.
Come she on, your pa. Pilates and all that. Oh, look at this. Come on. Okay, I'm stepping on out of. I'm in Yonkers, y'all. This is a. Oh, this DMX is over here buried in here. But you see this, we all go to the grave anyway. So I'm just going to say, I'm reminded by this 17. You got banging on the thing. All right. But yeah, but no, that's true. Yeah, Pa's my girl. We had a great Bible study today. I love her so much. She's anointed and appointed. She's anointed. I'm going to go back on mute.
This not what?
Crystal.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So. Don't you realize that you're cutting your options way, way down with that kind of mindset?
Look, no, I don't. Fat men don't approach me anyway, so.
Well, he doesn't have to be fat. You're saying the man need a six pack and all of that.
Okay. That's men are supposed to be flat bellied. I like flat belly men, okay? What's wrong with you? Why you keep getting on me because I like flat belly men? Just because y'all don't like fat women, so why are you getting after me because I like what I like? I don't understand, man.
What I'm saying, what's the chances of those men liking you?
Look, I get hit on by nothing, but I don't get hit on by.
None doesn't, but I'm just saying, what's the chance of those men liking you?
Anyway, I don't know. Anyway, I'm done. So I don't know
what to say. What about, so you're saying the man can't have a stomach?
No, man can't have no
stomach.
She said a six pack. That's crazy, man. And so what are you, are you a cougar?
You can't have a flat stomach, Crystal?
She must be talking about a younger guy, Moshe. Crystal, are you a cougar?
A what?
A cougar.
A cougar? What's a cougar?
Like an older woman that wants a younger man.
No, I don't want a younger man.
Okay, so let me hit you with something. The average guy, as he gets older, develops a stomach. Unless he works out and he has good eating habits, Yeah, you notice most older men starts to develop a gut.
And then some men, yeah, and then some men just have high metabolism rate. Some men just, some people can't get fat.
Okay, and those guys are skinny.
And so I like men who are, I don't care if
Let me ask you something, Crystal. How many of those guys have you been out with?
I've been out with one time.
How long ago was that?
Over a year ago.
Okay. So what happened with that? Why are you not with him?
I don't know. He just moved on.
Do you think that might have anything to do with how you carried yourself, or why do you think he just moved on? Because people don't just do things, right?
Anyway.
There's usually always a reason. Why do you think he just moved on?
Well, anyway, he never he just never been with nobody. You know, he likes small women like you. So
okay, so how did you end up going out with him?
I don't know.
So Crystal, so like a woman could a woman could be, when you say small, you don't really know what I like, right? So when you say small, what do you mean? What's small to you?
A man who doesn't have a big fat stomach.
No, I mean a woman. You say small women like me. So what would a small woman consider to be? What's her weight?
A small woman, I guess, would like Moshe.
Okay, but what's a small woman's weight? Because I don't know what Moshe's body look like. What does a small woman's weight look like?
I don't know, flat stomach.
So you don't have to be small to have a flat stomach. I've seen a lot of big women in the gym that has a flat stomach.
But I don't know. I guess I don't know what I'm talking about then.
No, I'm just trying to get an idea of what you're saying here. Like, what do you consider small?
I don't know. I just like slim men.
No, and women, what would be considered small? What size?
I don't know. 14, 16, I don't know.
You say 14 to 16?
I guess.
That's not small, Crystal.
Oh, okay.
That's not small.
Okay, maybe a size 2 then.
No, that's small.
Okay.
That may be a little too small. You're getting into Edomite territory now.
That's what I was thinking.
Anorexic. You're getting into anorexics, right? Models that starve themselves. A 14 is big though, Crystal. That's like Jenny Craig type thing. Lane
or
Bryant.
Lake.
Yeah, Lane Bryant.
Ashley Stewart.
Huh.
Wait a minute. They could not say Ashley Stewart. I haven't heard that in a God forgive me, God. Oh my God. Y'all are too bad. No, but back to the topic that hit y'all. I believe that holy matrimony. That a man and a woman together complements each other, one flesh, right? And so I don't think anybody should be alone. I think it's nice to have us. So back to that, you know. So Crystal, so what? Okay, you're not gonna probably find a love thinking that way.
Nope.
If you know, now I'm not trying. I'm just saying, maybe consider. Okay. The personality, right? Also, you know, I can't tell you what to like, girl. Oh, Shay. Okay, Shay. Now you ain't. Now you know you supposed to have hit me up. Now I'm just like,
hey, you know what? I believe it or not. You're in New York too, right?
So I'm joking, girl.
Bunch of snow. I'm just now on my way home from work.
Hey, girl. I was just joking. Hey. I miss you.
Oh, miss you too.
It's icy out here. There's ice all over the car. This is all ice, y'all. All ice. Yeah. Be careful, y'all.
Hey, Crystal.
Yes.
So, but let's think let's look at this realistically, right? So if you really want a man, you want a man that's actually also interested in you, right?
Yes.
You don't want to be just a pump and dump or a hit and run. You want a long-term relationship, right?
Yes.
So you have to get a man that's actually going to also be attracted to you.
Yes, okay.
So, I mean, so here's the option. You could lose weight, get slimmer.
Okay.
And no, that will raise your chances higher. I'm just being realistic. But there are guys out there, or you're going to have to actually go and look for some of those guys that like what they refer to as big, beautiful women. That like to drink a lot.
Can I say what I would want in a man, please?
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead, please.
A man who follows the Most High, who knows the scriptures, who can lead me not into darkness but into light. To learn from him things that I don't know. You know, romance and stuff like that. But nowadays, I don't know if chivalry is dead or, you know, loving one another. I'm a passionate person. I love passion, right? But let's just face it. After a while, because I've been in a 10-year relationship, common law marriage, really, and then a 4-year marriage. So that dies out. So we got to find ways to spark it. So I like, you know, a funny person, a charismatic, someone who's honest. Honesty. Honesty is number one. Matter of fact, so I'll put that on the top right there, being, follow of the Most High, meaning he's not a perfect man, but, you know, perhaps he's looking to, you know, he's looking for him. He seeks him, right? So he's not going to be perfect. Nobody's perfect, right? But he strives to be like that. And then, oh, no, we could just go. Oh, and then, oh, you know what? Matter of fact, you're right. Yeah, I'm going to go to some. Sorry, bro. You know, he's striving to be perfect, and he can lead. No, to this one. And he could lead, you know, I'll be real quick. He could lead and also kind, loving. We can work together as a team. We can, you know, we're supposed to be partners. That's the point. He said, y'all become one flesh. And so, you know, just doing life together, you know, building, raising up children to serve the Most High, you know, that'd be funny if I fall. That would be so funny if I fall on this YouTube, like, poof. You know, raising up children, you know, that y'all would really get a good laugh at that. Now I'm playing. Raising up children, someone who's not easily distracted, not a drunkard, someone who has self-control. You know, that way when one is down, when one of us is down, one of us can help each other get up. You get what I'm saying? Look at y'all, because y'all could just look like a dead man's man. I don't even know.
Yeah.
Anyway, you get what I'm saying, y'all? So that's what I love. Y'all can hear me still?
Yeah, we can.
Of, you know, like passion and companionship, best friend. Remember, the Bible says they should become one flesh. So if you're married to a rapist, this is why I had to do that. If you're married to a rapist, spiritually, you could probably become that. If you're married to a fornicator, a gambler, a drunkard, we become one flesh. So I want to be able, if I'm down, somebody to give me a word of inspiration of got my back, I got your back, memories together, traveling together, working together as one unit. One soul, one flesh. Hallelujah.